Thank you. so much. His life has been a high cross test in the service of God and humanity. His father again is well known to all of us in this country. He did not live his life himself, but lived his life absolutely in the service of others. He was always ready to go extra kilometers in the service of others with his time, his talents, his energy, without counting the cost. He fought for democracy to be enforced in this country. He fought for democracy to be re-enforced in this country. His own thoughts cannot be changed. His soul lives forever. Born again, he's God's general. He's not an athlete general or a military general. God made him a general. A man who left a legacy of honor and selfless service. He was dedicated to honesty, passion for freedom, democracy, and social justice. Chibuike was very honest, blunt, and he was a multilingualist, a political philosopher, and an accomplished constitutionalist. All of us, we believe that his death is a monumental loss to this nation. Today, we are thanking God for his invaluable contributions and want to pray that his soul will rest in peace in the name of Jesus Christ. I want us to turn to our Bible. And open to the first epistle of Paul to the Thessalonians, chapter 4, verse 17b. The Bible says, and so forever we shall be with the Lord. St. Paul wrote this epistle to the It is now imperative for the leader of government to continue